The Power of Water Baptism. If you have sat down as Jesus instructed and counted the cost of becoming his disciple, if you are willing to surrender to God's mercy and grace on his terms, the first step is to be water baptized. Just as Jesus was water baptized to fulfill all righteousness, so too his disciples walk as he did, in full obedience to God. 1 John 5:7 and 8 teaches us that three things are equal in God's sight. 1. The Holy Spirit. 2. The water of purification. 3. The sanctifying blood of Jesus. The full message of the good news teaches these to be of equal importance. The Holy Spirit is of value. The blood of Jesus is the same value. And finally, the water has equal power. For there are three that testify: the Spirit, the water, and the blood, and the three are in agreement. 1 John 5:7 and 8. The power over sins in your life starts with being united with Jesus, like this in his death. Romans 6:5. By no means. We died to sin. How can we live in it any longer? Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. If we have been united with him like this in his death, we will certainly also be united with him in his resurrection. Romans 6, 2-5. This is why in Acts 2:28, when the group cried out to be saved from their sins, people taught that they should repent and be baptized for the forgiveness of sins. Like Jesus, they too are promised the Holy Spirit when being water baptized. When the people heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the other apostles, "Brothers, what shall we do?" Peter replied, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." Acts 2:37 and 38. When anyone asks, "What shall we do?" there should be one united response: count the cost, repent, and be baptized for the forgiveness of sins. No wonder the Apostle Peter compared the power of water baptism to Noah and the flood. As the floodwaters cleansed the world, saved Noah and his family, it also contains great power for those who come to God on his terms. Peter wrote in 1 Peter 3:21, "And this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also." Peter wrote with sound doctrine that water baptism saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter 3:21. For the Apostle Peter, water baptism derives its power from the resurrection of Jesus. For more on the full message of the good news, visit www.luke1425.org.